YouTube, what's happening? So it's your boy Dom, and we are here in Secaucus getting the bus fixed. There's like a crack on the windshield. It's like right there where that white spot is on the bottom, right there. So we're getting the whole windshield replaced. But cool story though. Where we are right now, it's owned by Academy. It's a spot called Body Right. But on the other side of this, we have some transit buses. And they're actually, most of them are brand new. And they're going to be put into service. Like this bus right here, the gentleman was just fixing the signboard. This bus right here is an express bus that's gonna go somewhere. They're like doing pre-delivery inspection on it, and it's gonna be delivered to MTA. So this is a new bus right here. This is a new bus, and like those are also all new buses. These are Prevost X345s, commuter styles, and these are Nova buses, low floors. These are the new hybrid electric buses that they have. They're not ours, so I'm not gonna go inside, because you know, like it may be like a security concern or whatever, but I'm definitely not gonna go inside. What I could say is that it's pretty cool. These are buses that are in service already. This one, not that one, but this one, from what I'm gathering so far, I think this bus is from Gun Hill in the Bronx, close by me. But up there, it's cracked. So pretty cool. I'm not gonna lie, being out here is pretty amazing. The weather's real good, and I'm actually happy. I'm not gonna lie, like when I was at prom, I was happy and I felt good, but like being here, I feel real happy. Like I've always loved bus driving more than I've liked truck driving anyway, but like, you know, because of the pandemic and how everything was shaped up, couldn't really like enjoy it as much as you'd like. But nonetheless, you know, we're here and we're bus driving again, and it's pretty cool. It's like, it's real cool. And the cool part about being at this particular location, like so many buses come in and out, you know? We have our buses, you got MTA buses, you know? And the thing is like, these guys, they come from all over New York City. So it's pretty interesting, you know what I'm saying? And it's nice, like I really enjoy it. Like Novas, these are just finished, or they're going back out to whatever garage they're going to. That's one of our Van Hools back there. That's a Port Authority bus over there. That's all of these right here are Port Authority buses, except for those, the J and the Prevo. And then next door, we're next to Peter Pan, cause you know, Peter Pan, they have their New York, New Jersey office right over there. And we're gonna keep walking. They got their New York, New Jersey office right over there. And like, I'm not gonna lie, like this is real cool. Behind the Port Authority bus, we have one of our commuter J's that services New Jersey. Like, I'm not gonna lie, like I feel like Academy is a real cool gig. Like, it really is. It spans all the way from up north and out of Braintree, Massachusetts, and it runs all the way down into Miami, Florida. And it goes as far west as Atlanta, Georgia. So like, it's a real cool outfit. And I'm enjoying my time here so far. Over there, there's an RTS, MCI, Van Hool, Prevo, H345. Like, I love this stuff. Over here, we have more MTA transit buses. Again, like, I'm not gonna go on that because they're not our buses to go on. But as you guys can see, we have a lot of equipment here. There's a lot of equipment that's being serviced. There's a lot of equipment that's being fixed. There's a lot of equipment that's being tested, and so on and so forth. And like, the cool part about it is, this is a service that Academy gives to other people, so like they're also able to help. But y'all, stay locked in. Don't mind the tears in my eyes. It's a little cold. It's not like cold, but it's a bit chilly. All right, back again. This is the inside of the H345 motor coach. I'm not sure how many it seats, but I'm pretty sure it's upwards of 50. But ironically, I've never driven an H. I've only driven X's. But this right here, is how the restroom looks or whatever. Never really been in one, like I said. I was in one the other day, but like I never like looked in it. I had to move it because the booty was sticking out. So I just moved it up so I could fit my bus in when I was in Florida. But it's pretty cool. One thing I like about the H models is that the passenger area is elevated. So like, you step into the coach, right? And then you come over here, you step up again, and the passenger area is back there. You know what I'm saying? So like, you the driver, this is your own area separate from everybody else. Like, this is one coach I've never had the opportunity to drive. But because of where I'm located, I don't think I'm gonna really have the chance to drive one. But nonetheless, these are pretty dope. Like, I've driven X models at Greyhound, so like, I have an idea. But like, over here, you have your parking brake, you have your tag wheel lift to make it go up and down. This says low boy or low buoy, whatever. I don't know what that is for. Over here, you have the driver window button. You have the heated mirror button, the luggage bay locks, cruise control, hydraulics for your up and down, for your front axle. You have your electric horn and your air horn, lights, all that cool stuff, you know? Like, this is real, real interesting. And like, you also have controls for the steering wheel, all that. But I'm gonna throw a picture in there so you guys can see what I was talking about. And like, just like a ton of other controls. And like, look, you're down here, your passengers are up here. So you have like that little bit of separation. I think this is really dope. Like, I think this is so dope. Like, when I drove at Greyhound, we had a similar setup, not 100% identical, but a similar setup. Like, this is dope. Like, this is so freaking dope. Like, I'm not gonna say I'm a bus nut, but I like buses. Like, buses come in so many different shapes, sizes, lengths, so many different you know, variations. This was cool. Like, being here is just so freaking cool. But yeah, like, see that? Look, yo, look at these things, man. Do you see these buses? These motor coaches? These things are dope, bro. Another quick bus tour. We're gonna look at the inside of the transit bus. If I'm not mistaken, I think this is an Orion 5. And cool story, I actually know how to drive these. Don't mind my nose running. As long as the battery is turned on, let's see what we're shaking with. Yeah, the battery not turned on, so we're not turning it on. So we're just gonna do that, put it back in the off position. But this is the inside of the Port Authority bus. This is actually one of the buses that services Newark, New Jersey. What the hell? Oh, I see what's going on here. Yeah, that's janky. But this is the inside. When I drove transit in Long Island, our buses were similar to this. But there were actually more seats. Yeah, there were more seats. But over here, luggage rack, you know, hand sanitizer, all that cool stuff. Back here, that's what it is. Not really much to say about these buses. Academy got the contract recently, so they're doing like a United Airlines type of shuttle thing at one part of the airport, and then on another part of the airport, they're doing the passenger service where they transport passengers around the airport as well. So, little quick thing. Slide this bad boy back up. I'm not sure if this is an Orion or a Flyer. Pretty sure it's an Orion though. I'm not gonna hold you. It may be a Flyer, but who knows? This right here is a Patera. This is what they call the potato bus. These right here, they are, if I'm not mistaken, 100% hybrid electric buses. Some people like them, some people don't. Personally, I've never been in one. I've never driven one. I don't know much about them. All I know is that they're hybrid electric buses, and a lot of individuals are not really big fans because they say that the batteries on them die or whatever the case may be. So yeah, this is the inside of it. Not much. One thing about transit buses are they're basically empty shells that you just throw seats in and the air conditioner and some handrails for people. But this is what the driver area looks like. Not gonna go too deep into it only because I don't know that much about it, but it is bus. So, you know, pretty interesting. Not really a fan, but yeah. But this is another one of the buses that goes to Newark Liberty Airport. Yeah. Independent operating front doors. Pretty cool. Let me lock it back up so they don't see I'm going into things and not closing it behind me. But yeah. But yeah, guys, that's really about it. You know, Academy is a very well-run, well-oiled machine. They definitely take care of their stuff, you know? If it's messed up, they send it out to get fixed. They bring it here to body right. If it's broken down on the side of the road, it gets picked up real quick and it gets taken care of. Definitely kind of hype. Like, I feel good being here. Like, I felt good being at Prime. I miss trucking. But, like, I feel good being here. I feel good being able to, like, move people, get them from A to B, allowing them to, like, go somewhere, and being a part of that experience for them, being a safe, reliable, professional bus operator, whether it's, like, a bus or a motor coach. Because, you know, one day we could be driving one of those, and then the next day we could be driving one of those. You know what I'm saying? So it's like, you got to be prepared.